That's it. What do we say to end our videos?
Dicks out. No, we
because she's like, she has the Tharja costume, the Tharja base costume, but I personally, like, I find Rosalina and Luma much prettier than Lucina, although Peach does have the daisy skin. Also, welcome back, it's matching.
The only reason why I don't know, I can't really judge thoroughly more through that is because I haven't played a lot of these other games.
Fair enough.
So I can't really just say, oh, this and that, because, I can't do that.
See, before the DLC, I played every character's game. Then there came Ryu, and I tried out Street Fighter. I liked it. And then there came Cloud. I haven't played Final Fantasy VII. And then there came Corrin. I can't marry Camilla because I don't have the game.
I haven't. No, she's definitely pretty. I would have said something if.
I'm not talking about Corrin. Corrin's the person you play as. You can marry one of Corrin's friends. They were raised together in the same house, and for a long time, Corrin thought it was her sister, or his sister. But they're not, so you can marry them, and she's big titty.
That makes sense, honestly. That makes a lot of sense with people.
And also, she could beat the crap out of you, so. Like, if look, I'm not for damsels in distress that happen to be extremely pretty. I'm all for people who could probably beat the crap out of me.
I understand.
I want, like, I still wouldn't look at other women. But yeah. I want there to be that threat of, if I look at another woman, I'm dead. I like how this episode didn't even start with fighting. Yeah. The first minute was just waifu talk.
Yeah.
This looks different. Oh no, it's the same. And we have all the Pokemon in the background. Have fun with that. Quiet the babysitter. Voicing Papyrus is gonna be fun with that.
I've barely done a lick of damage to you, because I'm more focused on that.
Have fun with that.
Can I not?
Oh!
I didn't realize he had such a jump.
Finishing touch. Your invincibility ran out.
Sucking right now, my mind's somewhere else, and
you're not sucking. Cloud is just a good character.
I know, but I do better than this. I at least do something.
You're better than Joelle.
Oh, thanks. That means a lot.
Oh, I tried to wall jump and it didn't, but I still made it back. I tried to wall jump and then spike you.
Oh my god. Oh.
Dang it! It wasn't high enough to kill. I have to hit you at the start of the attack. Oh, I thought I would hit you into it.
That would've been pretty cool. God, you're so good at Ryu.
Oh, I thought I got you.
He has such a high freaking
recovery.
Yeah. I mean, that's good, but that could also be bad.
Yeah. But you can aim it. Like, mid-thing, you could change the direction of it. But then when you land, the end lag.
Yeah, no, yeah. Oh!
See that end lag? Oh!
The swords. This is not good. This is not good for me at all.
Oh! Get that damage in. Wait, Registeel! No!
No! Oh, shit!
That's what Registeel does. He messes with the swords.
It's not that bad. Could have been worse.
It could kill you at high enough percents. I remember once I got juggled on
the swords.
I really
could have done better on this game. Oh, that was bad. That was
really bad. It was. As I fall off into the distance.
I'm not satisfied with myself. I could have done better. Really not satisfied right now.
I like how you also, like, don't like calling someone a waifu if you haven't played their game yet.
I mean, yeah, it's only fair. I mean, I don't know you, so why am I just gonna look at you and say, like... What?
That's very... I agree. You know, it's very hard being... I say this. It's gonna sound pretentious, but it's very hard to be someone who, like, is kind of old-timey romantic. Like, you get with some... be with them for as long as you live.
Yeah.
Like, it's very hard to be one of those people in a... What? Oh, apparently it's chic, too, or something.
That sucks.
Or not. I don't know. I fought Sheiks online. What's that?
Wait, you fighting online with the character too? Lag breaks it?
Yeah, because it has to read this to find the character. Unless it's DLC. Dilk. I don't. Go back quick before something bad happens. Crap.
Keep doing that until I pick the character, I guess.
30.
What?
What?
Huh?
What did you... What?
I'm in the Planet Wisp part.
Oh, God.
I'm just guessing the amount of resets.
24. No, wait, no. Wrong level. I think. You were 14 minutes in. How did you get to Planet Wisp already?
Huh?
We ended at 1454.
Yeah, but... Don't you forget, like, when you continue a video after...
I'm gonna wait until it starts. Okay. It's difficult being a type of person who wants... Who, like... If you're gonna hook up with someone, you wanna make sure it's gonna last and not just like. It's difficult being an old timey romantic in a hookup society.
Yeah.
Because everyone's just like, hey, we dated once. It's like, what do you mean? Did it not work out because of the fight? No, we just. You have to make sure you want.
One time thing, yeah. What?
Yeah, like, what? You can't.
Oh,
like,
no, she was pretty. I loved her, but.
or the thing where they're like, I guess it'd be fun.
It was fun. Well, it lasted.
It's not supposed to be something you do for fun. It's a thing you do. Like, yeah, fun is involved, but it's a thing
it's
you do.
It's not like... It's not like a freaking...
It's not... Love is not a game! It's not like... If you want love to be a game, go download, like, goddamn, what's it called?
Freaking...
Honey Pop! You want love to be a game? Download Honey Pop. This is the real world.
And even then, video games explain better that it's not supposed to be that way.
You saw the Game Theory, right? Where they talk about how, like, dating sims
accurate. I've seen that one, yeah. There was this one app game that I downloaded that is, like, you know, those things, like animes where you're the main protagonist and there's multiple women that you can choose from to... go out with and stuff like that, but you have to work towards it and shit.
Yeah.
I've, like that, and there's, like, multiple endings because you can choose different women to go after.
Yeah.
Like, I've done that, you know, and it's accurate. You have to get on their good side, you know, do the right thing.
Yeah,
and,
like
know?
The girl I like right now, which I'm not gonna say her name because anyone from school could find this video, and I don't want rumors to start.
I mean, what is it? Technically, I can't really say anything too well because the game, the app game, it wasn't as advanced that way. It was more like, you have, points to unlock the story to see what happens next. It was more of a, you watch and see what happens next, and then it stops to a to be continued. Like, those annoying parts where you're just like, oh, you fucking bitch. I see that.
Yeah, but anyways, what I was saying was, like, the person I like right now, one of my favorite things is
gosh,
that she's
darn
very,
it.
Like, she's very respectful. She doesn't, like, she didn't just say yes because I'm someone who happens to be interested in her. Like, she wants to make sure that there's a connection, which is really good. Like, she's respectable. And I'm not saying you're not respectable if you, like, date someone because they think you're good looking, even if you don't like them. Because, hey, life's short, and you can live it however you want. But I just prefer to not... I don't want it to be a one-time thing, because I used to not believe in, like, the whole
love
zodiac...
Sight or
no, zodiac signs and all that.
Oh.
And, like, then they all got me accurate, and I decided to look some of them up.
I know, yeah.
And it's very accurate.
They do that. They're made to do that. I mean, they do.
I didn't realize how accurate they were to when you were born. I was like, there's no way you could tell someone's personality by when they were born. Yeah, you can. But anyways, the point I was getting to with that was, like, I found out that Aquariuses, apparently, are very kind of... They get attached easily in relationships, and
yeah.
That is very true.
Yeah, it is.
Like, I
we're all three, just letting you know if no one knows that, me, Joel, and Jordan are Aquarius.
Yeah, so it's very hard for me to let go of a relationship. Even with someone I hate, I can't actually actively go out of my way to hate them unless they done something really bad.
Right.
I tried to run off an attack. But, like... I just noticed, we got surprisingly deep in this game of Smash.
I know, yeah.
But, like, I wouldn't be able to make something a one-time thing, because I'm going to get attached. And I wouldn't go after someone unless I already am sure about my decisions. That was nice.
I'll give you that one, yeah.
I mean, take everything we say with a grain of salt. We're teenagers, what do we know?
Yeah.
But, like, one thing I know for sure is... Love is not a toy.
You don't, like, abuse it. You don't play around.
You don't... Like, one thing I found recently is being single is an upgrade from being with someone who doesn't want you.
Yeah.
And it's very true, because I... Like I said, I don't hate someone I'm friends with once unless they did something terrible. And my best friend and, my best friend, her ex, never actually liked her in the first place. And they were dating for 2 years.
Should you be saying this?
It's not like I'm saying her name.
Still, like, I mean, she's gonna know who she is if she does.
She didn't watch her videos.
Okay.
Unless I show them to her.
Okay.
Either way, like... Either way, she'd respect that I didn't say her name.
Right. Because
we've talked about this sort of stuff before, and like, she says, as long as, like, people don't say the person's name when talking about personal stuff like that, it's fine. But, like... I tried to spike you. But, like, that is...
What?
Your momentum carried downwards. But, like, it's... The fact that he, like, strung her along for that long, and the worst thing is, when he was finally okay with letting go of the relationship, he essentially just used her to boost his confidence, like, hey, someone actually likes me. I don't need them anymore, and...
Okay.
I wanted to punch him in the face.
Okay.
They're friends now. I'm not befriending that dude, no matter what.
Mega Man!
Joker imposter, son of a bitch.
Okay,
he dyed his hair green.
No, okay. What is it? I was gonna say. There was this one friend that I had. Well, I still do have. And, I mean, I guess she's somewhat a friend. It's one of those friendships where you can't really tell. But, you know, you are at the same time. You know, you hang out with a person.
Yeah, it's your stage pick.
Oh, sorry. But, yeah, I had this one friend, I believe it was her sister, she was going out with this one dude, and, so she was going out with this one dude, and, while she was going out with him, they've been dating for a while, and, they were, like, supposedly, like, really, really, like, in love and stuff like that and everything, and apparently, this guy, he had gotten together with her, What?
Oh, yeah, that. Anyways.
What was that?
Oh, that, I remember, that's the part where you put "you were too slow" on screen and I just died inside. No, we don't use rule out! We don't use, okay. What were you saying? Apparently
yeah.
This guy, like...
So, apparently this guy, he got together with her, just to get together with her because, there was, this other girl that he used to date that, like, let him go or something. I don't know how that really worked, but, anyway, he really liked her, and he only basically did it to... get her to really notice him more and to make her, like, I guess, jealous or something. Or wait, no, maybe that's not how it really worked. It was,
He's mine now.
I'm so confused.
He won't hurt me. His attacks can't hurt me, they only hurt you now.
I'm still making conversations hard for me.
Yeah, same.
But,
the screen's kind of blurry.
Oh!
And I'm showing him who's he's my bitch again. I just keep attacking him. I'm showing him who's boss. He's my bitch. Just asserting my dominance all over his dragony face, and he's gone. Anyways, so he was only using her to.
No. I might have gotten it a little bit more wrong. He was going out with this girl for a while, and they went out for a while, and they did their thing and stuff like that. But apparently, out of nowhere, his ex or something came back from wherever she was. Like, I guess she got moved or something, and she came back. And she was like, I want you again, and blah blah blah, something like that. And he decided, I'm just gonna really be with her then.
Yeah, that's
so he got back to he got back together with the girl, and his current girlfriend found out, and like he was just saying, and he literally said to her, sorry, like I was more with you just because of the sex.
That's bullshit.
And I was like, okay, you know, that's pretty dick move. Holy shit.
it also took until the person I have a crush on now to realize that I had the so sorry Jack mentality in a sense. I was like, well, I'm being super nice to this girl. Why does she like me? Which is how I thought with my previous crush. Now I know it's not at all that. It's, first of all, your personalities have to go well together. You have to be able to hold a conversation with this person. Like, you can't just like someone because of the looks, and just because you could talk for at least 5 minutes. Like, if at least 5 minutes, look, your at least has to be an hour, okay? And like, you both have to find each other attractive.
I really do.
She's not gonna get with you just because you think she's attractive. It's not up to what you think. Get dunked on. Well, that wasn't really a dunk.
I was gonna say that, yeah.
I tried to attack you. Anyways, but like, that's one thing that upsets me. See, I wish if I had a time machine, first thing I'd do, go back and make men and women equal. Because, see, the thing is, I want equality for women. I just don't like being treated like a shitbag just because I'm a dude.
Yeah.
I'm one of the dudes who likes equality for women.
Right.
Just because I happen to, like, one thing I find annoying is, just because I find women hot doesn't mean I'm a misogynistic asshole. That's like saying anyone who finds anyone hot is an asshole. That's like, no!
Oh no, you're just a pervert. You just want this and that.
No! I'm sorry that I have to listen to my biological functions.
Freaking free fall.
You weren't in free fall. You
no,
didn't use your ulti yet.
Well, no, I did. I started jumping. It was the gravity, I mean.
I thought I pressed shield, but. Oh, right, 7 frames. That one. Anyways, but like. Like. I want equality and all that. I was hyped for the Ghostbusters all-female reboot. And see, one person made a good note. Someone was like, make an all-female cast of this. And then someone said, hey, how about, here's another idea. Make an all-female cast that isn't in a reboot. So that way, it's an original movie. If it's a blockbuster, that's amazing. Another thing Suicide Squad was really good at. The main cast was all, like, there was one white dude in the main cast. The other three dudes were an Australian, a black guy, and a crocodile. two strong female lead characters and a strong female villain. Like, that's very progressive, and I love when that happens. Like, also another thing people complain about is Samus. If she could kick your ass, she could wear whatever the fuck she wants.
Honestly.
Like, it's not like she's being, like...
They make so many, like, sexual jokes. Stripper jokes and shit.
Actually, before you go back real quick. So people complain about these two costumes.
Right.
Designed by a woman. A woman designed these costumes for Samus, and people say it's misogynistic. No one complains about this. Samus is a 20-something-year-old who could do whatever the fuck she wants.
Right.
Shulk is 18. Just at that age of consent mark. Yeah, I wish I could play Shulk, but the
CD I would have known if you did that. I would have just played Samus just to fuck around.
back on the main topic of I wish I could go back in time and make it so men treated women equally from the beginning. Like,
right.
Everything was equal from the start. Because one, it's tiring to see one thing that's annoying. Actually, me and my friend, I'm going to ask if we could do this. I'm going to find shorts that are just revealing as the one she has.
Yeah.
And then if a teacher complains about hers, I will go off on them for not complaining about mine. Oh, I thought that wouldn't hit me. Because there's so many double standards. Like, oh, so she can wear shorts that are, like, not even that revealing. It's not like it shows her butt or anything. It's just shorts.
Right.
But, like, someone else in the classroom who happened to be a dude was wearing, like an A shirt, which is those things that that people sometimes call wife beaters. But no one batted an eye. Like, it's stupid. You slid on the ground. It's stupid the fucking double standards that humanity has toward, like, if a man does it, it's fine, but if a woman does it, no.
Yeah.
A man can walk around shirtless, but girl, cover up those naughty bits, like, fucking... It should be equal. Oh my god, your shield...
I know!
Your shield is gone. But like... This is actually really fun, talking about serious topics while playing Smash.
It is fun.
Oh,
fuck. Well, I'm not doing really well.
Yeah, the point isn't to do well. It's kind of like a backdrop to the main conversation.
I know, but I want to do well. I'm doing a lot worse than I was when I was focusing.
Yeah, but it's also fun to be able, like... We have 130-something subscribers. No one's gonna hear this, but it's still fun to be able to vent about things and possibly make a difference in the world.
Right.
Especially when you feel like you're talking for the right cause.
Yeah.
And we're also not covering anything too controversial. It's not like we're talking about politics
cancer
or something.
Shit.
Cancer needs to fuck off, okay? Hey, cancer, can you stop being a disease for like 5 minutes and let people live?
Can you stop? Yeah.
But like... you were too far away. Oh, fuck. But, like... I've been saying but, like, a lot.
Yeah, no, yeah.
That was a fast match.
It was, because I'm doing bad.
2 minutes!
I'm doing bad.
It took 2 minutes! 2 minutes, 1 second.
I'm doing really bad.
Yeah.
And
it's
this
fun
is,
to get
this
some
is
practice.
My main.
It's fun to get some practice.
It's not the practice, like... I always need practice, but still. I'm talking, and I'm listening to you.
No,
well.
I'm talking about me getting practice. On this body bag over here.
Oh, well, thank you.
Body bag!
I appreciate being used for the cause.
But what were we talking about again? Oh, as much as I want equality for women, there's feminists and then there's feminazis. Feminism is about equality. It has the name feminism because it didn't used to be equality for everyone, it was just equality for women. Then people of color came into the mix, and it's like, yeah, we want equality for women, but we also want equality for people who, like, are dark-skinned, or, like, Asian, or stuff like that.
Yeah.
But they kept the name. I feel like it should just be equalism?
Equalism.
Because feminism has now been used as, like...
Right.
A thing, like, I want men to start rotting in hell. Women, I want equality for only
women.
Yeah,
you've seen, like, the memes, right?
Yeah. Like, I know not all feminists are like that, because I'm a feminist. Bitch. I'm a feminist. I call men bitches more than I call... I feel bad calling women bitches. Just because you forgot to ear up the LSD as well.
No, I was trying to do the grab. I was gonna up B. I was gonna up B, but I would try to do the little grab that he can do. This I was trying to do.
Oh!
What?
No. Okay. Okay, Link, time to introduce you to the real world.
Oh!
Welcome to the real world. But like, what were we talking? Equality is one thing. Total domination is another. Yes, I realize men treated women wrong the entire time, but feminism isn't about getting back. It's about getting equality.
Right?
Like, first of all,
no!
Limit just makes me heavier and my attacks do
no! No!
And my finishing touch can't kill you right now.
I don't care. I don't like it.
One of my favorite lines from, speaking of feminism, one of my favorite lines from Bo Burnham's Words rap was, bitches and hoes, hoes, bitches and hoes, bitches, hoes, and then the next line that's overlaid over bitches and hoes is, bitches and hoes don't exist because the hoes know Bo's a feminist.
Triggered. Oh,
you're too far away.
That backflip.
But like, anyways, what was I saying? Something about feminism and equality. But like, that's another reason why, like, I made my, what?
26.
We go to 30.
Oh.
But like, I made my OC Max, like, a lot of people make their OCs a different skin color than them, and while that's fine, I wanted to keep Max with my skin color, because let's say I do end up making a video game with him, which I plan to, and it ends up doing well. It'd be a video game where the two main characters are people of color,
right,
and Max travels to different dimensions. Every single dimension, the female character is the boss of Max. You play as Max, yeah, he's the main character. In the pirate dimension, Max is the first mate, and Smiles is the captain. In the dimension where they're Grim Reapers, he's the Grim Reaper, and she's Death herself. No matter what, she's the boss of him.
So you're like, flipping.
Yeah, even though it's his game, she's still the more powerful, stronger one.
No, I always agree. I'm one of those people, like, that's just, like, my list is, like, oh, that's, like, men are better, or, like, women are, like, this and that. Like, when they stereotype shit, like, oh, like,
men are stronger and women are smarter. Why can't we all be both?
And then that's why people they ask me sometimes when I play a game with my family or something, or my friends, they ask me, why are you playing as a girl or something? Because girls are fucking strong in this game.
Yeah,
that's why I respond. They're really good.
But like, what was it? Like, that's another reason, a good example of this. Peach and Daisy.
Right.
They are basically palette swaps of each other. Their only real thing different is their voices and their hair. And their color. And their attitude. That's the thing I was getting to. Their only real physical difference is their voices, their hair, and their outfits. But the thing I like is, other than their voices, because Peach's voice, it would be fine. I wouldn't mind hearing Daisy with Peach's voice. As a matter of fact, Daisy used to have Peach's voice. It's the fact that Daisy is a sports, outdoors person. That's why she doesn't appear on the Mario Adventures. Well, I wish she had a game of her own, but at the same time, like, if she had a game, she better be, like, Samus level of badassery. Because
I don't think she would. Oh, good guess.
She does sports. All she does is sports.
Right.
While Peach is out having tea parties with Mario and Luigi, Daisy's out practicing her back
game before.
Yeah, she had her game. The game revolved around her using her emotions. Yes. The main mechanic of the game was using anger, sadness, joy, and calmness to help. Calmness healed you. Happiness made you float. Sadness made you cry tears and run really fast. And anger made you move slowly but like destroy everything in your path. And it also revolved around her using the dildo. I wish I could say that was kind of a joke. What else do you call a vibe scepter? And the game describes it as if one
what
day
what do they look like? I'm sure I'm curious.
It's a staff. But one of the best things is at the game it says, but maybe if you end up hearing your mom in the other room going through some emotions, maybe she's found the vibe scepter too. This is the best thing. It's like, God damn it, Nintendo. Princess Peach is the only game and you make a dildo joke. But like, if Daisy has a game, she better be like running around. She better move at the same speed as Mario and Luigi, because Peach is slow whenever she's in the game. She's the slowest character. Daisy better run just as fast as Luigi. Also, my favorite thing about the stuff with, like, Luigi and Daisy shippers is that Daisy is always the dominant one. Daisy's always the one pushing Luigi around, which fits for their personalities.
Yeah.
But, like, Daisy is, like, very energetic and, like, what?
Did you purposely put Luigi upside down?
Yes. Same thing with Plato. Oh, you're at the credits? But like, I wish you could hit Kamek and stop
him for a moment.
But like, where are we at? Oh yeah, Daisy's the more powerful one, which is why I like Daisy. Same thing with, like, I like creepy characters and powerful characters. And, before we end this episode off, another character I really like is Harley Quinn, because she could beat the crap out of you, she's smart, she uses her sexuality to her advantage, not as a crutch, and on top of that, she could probably will kill you in your sleep.
See, but they do stereotype the shit out of it with, oh, we'll use that to our advantages.
Well, here's the thing. If you have something, use it. And even then, she used it, like, back in school to bring her grades up, and that was it. Afterwards, it was like, oh, I'm trapped in a corner, and there's, like, 50 people after me. That's the only time she uses her sexuality to her advantage. Otherwise, she just beats crap out of people. But, like, powerful female characters who happen to look good are amazing. Because, okay, I know I said I didn't on Harley's note, but Bayonetta is another example. She's a powerful female character who's sexy, she knows it, and on top of that, Umber witches, they're more powerful the sexier they are. So they're not being sexy just for the sake of it, they gain power from their sexuality.
Which is another thing.
Yeah, but at the same time, like, people say, oh, they're making standards for us to live up to, so you're saying that I now have to live up to Littermax's standard, because he's a dude? Or I have to live up to Kratos' standard, do I have to go out and kill a god? No, they're video game characters, you don't have to live up to their standards, the games are there for you to put yourself in the place of the character. Yeah, like, I mean, yeah, I'm not gonna put myself in the place of a monk of Donkey Kong. I'm not gonna go out in only a tie and start punching people. But like,
I'm sorry, I got a mental image of that. And what made it funnier is, it made it even funnier because I thought of this point right here is where Joelle would have clipped to an actual video of you doing that.
I'm gonna ask Idalis if I could borrow her red tie and like put DK on it so I could go around, walk up to someone and just punch them and then and edit the DK. Okay! I'm gonna do that!
I mean, it would have been funnier if you had like your shirt off and everything just be DK, but.
I don't feel comfortable. But like,
I know.
Anything else, I probably would, but the only chance I'd get would be at school.
Yeah.
And I'm not doing that at school. But like, anyways. What I want to end off on is equality is equality. People have sexuality and all that. People can be sexy if they want. People are born different ways. No matter how you're born, you're a beautiful person. Everyone's equal. Someone will love you. Everyone's beautiful, and everyone should just shut up and let everyone be who they are. Sorry, I got off on a tangent that was completely different from everything else. Look,
you were just covering everything so that. Not that there would, but, I mean, if you were a lot more popular people in the comments, oh, you forgot to mention this, too.
Yeah, like, you could be whatever gender you choose to be, you could be whatever sexuality you choose to be, or you could be the one you were born with, it's up to you. You could, like, love who you want, you could love yourself, be, like, believe what you want. Every human being is unique, and I feel like society tries taking away that. Is uniquity a word? Uniquity? I'm gonna say it.
Word, but, yeah.
I'm still gonna say it. Society tries to take away people's uniquity and tries to make unique people feel bad. And then, like, Idalis put it the best way. She said, the way society has it is, like, she likes something weird. And society doesn't let her have the middle ground of being popular. It's either, oh, you like this? Well, you're weird. Or, yeah, everyone likes this. Fuck you, you're not special. Society, like, that's exactly what she wrote, by the way.
So basically, yeah, if you don't like what everyone else likes, you're weird. But if you like something different from what else everyone else likes, you're weird.
Yeah, and if you like what everyone else likes, oh, you're not special.
You're special.
Idalis is kind of upset because, like, ever since Suicide Squad, she likes the iteration of Harley. People are gonna start calling her a fake fan. Even though she's liked Harley since her debut in Batman the Animated Series, and has cosplayed as every single Harley so far. Except for New 52. Fuck New 52. That's not Joker. Harley loves Joker. Why do they change that? Why is she like, no, I'm not being in this abusive relationship. Yes, it's an abusive relationship. That's bad. They showed what would happen if they switched places. If Joker was nice, she'd beat the shit out of him. She's just as bad as him.
I
just finished the whole movie.
Sweet. At the same time, I also kind of feel bad for her history, like who she was before. She won Dead Brain, but
Dead Brain?
I don't know how to. I chose the wrong words. More like went insane. But
oh yeah, she went insane. Well,
she's
always
like,
if she didn't mean the Joker, she'd be a con artist. She's a villain.
No, I'm saying like before that when she was like a therapy doctor or some shit.
She was a con artist.
What?
She went to school for like all that stuff. She was failing, and so she had sex. She slept with her teachers to bring her grades up. She would have been a con artist if she didn't end up with
the Joker. But what about all those other comments that they have that though, where it's like she's like more of a therapy doctor for the crazy, and she was sitting down like with the actual Joker.
Oh, she was. That was just for the money. If she didn't end up with the Joker, she would have just moved on to another job and continued being a con artist. Although I'm not like the full authority. If you have questions, please go talk to Idalis. We're working on a YouTube channel. We're not gonna say the name of it. That's all we're saying. Idalis and I are working on a YouTube channel. That's where it ends. But the final thing, this is the actual final thing. Everyone is equal. We're all born equal. We're all born on this earth. Whether you were born in a hospital, born naturally, born in the middle of fucking nowhere, born in a taxi, it doesn't matter. We're all equal. We're all human beings. So why can't we just learn to respect each other and treat each other right?
It doesn't matter if you have,
dark skin, light skin.
Dark skin, light skin. Like, if you were born when you have a deformity,
a mutation, genetic mutation.
Yeah, but I was talking about stuff that keeps you down from doing other things, like
handicap or disability.
Yeah, it's not the word I'm looking for, but yeah, it all works. It all works well. Yeah,
we all have. It doesn't matter if you're dark skin or light skin, long hair, short hair. If you're a male, female, every single thing in between, it doesn't matter if you're straight, if you're gay, if you're every single thing in between, it doesn't matter if you have boobs or a dick, you're human, and that's all that matters.
It doesn't even matter if you're a hybrid.
Yeah,
it doesn't matter,
because there are some people that are like that.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter. Like, we're all human.
Animal hybrid. It don't matter, you person.
You're still a human being. You were born on this earth. We have this one tiny rock. We're all here. Like, I don't think people realize how small. Like, yeah, it's gigantic. You know, if you took every human being, you could probably fit, not even, you wouldn't even be able to fill the Grand Canyon with it. But still, the earth is small. We all have to share it, so we might as well all just get along with each other.
Otherwise, we're gonna.
Sure.
Can I say something? Shout out to all those people making their dreams a reality. Always think positive, never negative. I know this is out of topic. I don't care. I even want to get something inspirational out there.
always you were feeling left out of the inspirational talk?
Yeah, so shout out to all those people that are making their dreams a reality. Also, always think positive instead of negativity. There's already enough negativity around the world, but just start spreading positive around this world, because all we hear in the news is bad shit, not even good shit. People don't even know there's this guy named, I don't know, Robert or something, I don't know, that did something good for a city or something.
I don't know, but like... we actually watched a documentary in film class. Oh, right, after we end the episode. Anyways, we're all on this small rock floating through space at thousands and millions of miles / kilometers per hour, like, hurtling towards our inevitable death when the Earth gets engulfed by the sun. We should enjoy our... and our lives are so short compared to the lifespan of the Earth, of the universe. There's no need to fill it with hatred and prejudice and segregation. We have to share this planet, so we might as well be nice to each other.
I mean, honestly, like, why not? If that's going to happen, why destroy ourselves before it does? Why give ourselves a shorter life?
Yeah. All the stress just shortens your life. So be happy and just be nice to people.
Be happy who you are.
Be happy with who you are and accept who other people are. Even if you don't agree with them, they're their own person. Let them be who they are.
Be the best version of you.
There's only one you. Might as well be 100% you.
I know.
I was adding. Let's just... That's it. This got heavy, and this went on for 40 minutes, but yeah, that's it. What do we say to end our videos? Dicks out. No, we were too deep.
Finish that.
No, we were too deep this episode. Dicks out for Harambe.